Hello guys, welcome back. How are you doing today? I figured that now would probably be a decent time to do a video discussing the changes in the last big old TF2 update, the Tough Break update. I decided not to just do one immediately after the update came out because I knew everyone would be doing that. So I decided, you know, I'd wait a little bit until the changes have actually sunk in, because people's opinions on some of the changes have changed over the last couple of days from their initial reactions. So I'm going to just dive right into it. I've got the Reddit upload update page right here on the right. I'm just going to kind of read off bits and talk about them. So the first major change is that everything in the update was a massive spy buff. Stuff like the rap assassin becoming more festive, that's a spy buff. Strange parts you can now add to any strange misc, that's a spy buff. But in all seriousness, though, like, everything is fries so good. This is the best update. I'm not kidding. This is, like, the best update in the history of the game. Not kidding at all. Like, the last best update, inverted commas, was the summer update from, like, I don't know, like, 2 years ago, when they rebalanced a bunch of weapons. Remember, like, the Saharan spy set, that got removed. The scout milkman set, that got removed. They made it so, like, the L'Etranger gives you the extra cloak. That kind of stuff. That rebalancing update was awesome. It was amazing. And then this update came out, and they updated. Well, let's just like scroll down, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, ones. Like, they've made it so the caber does a bit more damage because people were complaining. Like, this is, like, really well thought out for an update. If you've been playing CSGO or you know anything about it, you'll know that somewhat recently Valve kind of just read numbers off a spreadsheet and made changes off of that. They were like, we want people to burst fire more and tap shoot. So, you know, instead of increasing accuracy on first shot, which it should be, in CSGO, your first shot with an AK-47, it has like a 1 in 4 chance to just miss. There's no reason for that to exist. But in order to nerf that, like spraying, because everyone sprays in CSGO, they basically just made it so every rifle's really inaccurate, and everyone hated that. They just did like a blanket nerf on everything, they didn't put any thought into it. And they did the same with pistols, they just added a revolver that one-shots everything, it's got the AWP stats on it, because I don't know why. But then the TF2 stuff went through fucking almost every weapon in the game, rebalancing it in some kind of team-based or competitive aspect. It's really, really good. Let me just talk about it a little bit more. For example, some of the changes, stuff like, even little things, the quickie bomb launcher, they doubled the fizzle time to 4 seconds, as weird as that sounds. The quickie bomb launcher, it's already pretty decent side grade, but with this 4 second kind of tick on it before it fizzles, you can actually run your demo man to mid now, and he can put down, like, a trap at the start on mid, and that's 4 seconds, you know, 1, 2, 3, that's enough time for someone to walk on the trap, whereas, you know, 1, 2 is not enough. So that's made the weapon way more viable in sixes, meaning that, you know, not everyone's going to run the exact same weapon, meaning that when matchmaking comes out, it won't just be really dry and stale. Stuff like rebalancing Demo Knight, it's not a massive nerf, but it's also not a massive buff either. It's a rework. It's really well done. So they've made it so that the way that, instead of, you know, just doing 185, 195 crits, whatever, all the time with all the swords and pissing everyone off, it's now done based on distance charged, which it should be. You shouldn't be able to just be critting, you know, melee distance by someone with a no random crit weapon. It's stupid. That's a stupid idea. So they fixed that. But they've rebuffed it by making that you can't, you know, Jirati them or milk them or make them bleed or anything. And they've changed, you know, the shields and stuff. They've made them a little bit less overpowered. So, you know, you can actually set a demo man on fire now, that kind of thing. They've nerfed the loose cannon, so you don't just get one shot with it anymore. That's pretty good. I think it only does about 120 now, something like that. So that's quite good. And a lot of stuff seems to be based on, like, speed. What I really did notice was just kind of speeding up the game in general. So, for example, here we go. Like, all the NG nerfs. Bit of a shame that they had to nerf the NG. Like, I feel kind of bad for the NG mains, because they kind of just got shat on with this update. But you look at the nerfs, there's stuff like, let's have a look. The sapper delay means that it's easier to take down a sentry if you coordinate with your team, because even if your spy gets killed, he still has like another half second in which you can shoot it with rockets and shit, and it'll be disabled. I think that might only be with sentries, I don't think it's with dispensers, because if you sap a dispenser it doesn't heal, so I don't know about that. But they've nerfed the jag, Because it has the high swing rate, so the fact that, you know, it was just an upgrade to the fucking knife at that point. Because if it got sapped, you know, it was easier to desap it, and you know, it was just good. So they've made it so it takes three hits now, which, 3 hits is a lot, but if you include the fact that it's extra swing speed, it's only like another half a second, and, you know, it's a nice, they've done a nice thing here. They've nerfed the Rescue Ranger a bit. Again, a little bit sad, but Rescue Ranger was a bit annoying, where you could literally hold down a fucking point by yourself as an NG, so it's nice to see they're kind of speeding that up. Everything with, like, the switch speeds, that's massive. The switch speed thing is huge. Although it doesn't seem like much, only, what was it, like, 1.7 seconds? 0.1 seconds. Something like that. Very small. It's actually massive, because it means that, for example, if you're playing sixes, if you're a scout, you can now switch to your pistol even faster and finish someone off even faster than you can aim, meaning that's an extra skill aspect to the game. Because right now, it's slow enough, or what it was slow enough that you could have enough time to line up a shot, but now you have the option of either waiting, you know, the extra half a second to line up, or just spamming it and hoping. It's the same with, like, you know, you can pull the shotgun out. The stock... Okay, let's talk about Pyro. I'm going to talk about Pyro now, because this is a massive thing about the update. People at first were saying it was a massive nerf, which I didn't understand, but I understood a little bit, because they just read it, and they saw the degreaser, and then they saw some reduced and removed and stuff, and no longers, and they were like, oh, it's a nerf. Pyro got a massive buff this update! And also quite a few reworks and a couple of nerfs and stuff, but overall, Pyro's buffed as a class. He's easier to play. They did lower the skill ceiling, in a way, if you'd like to think about it, but they've also made him less bullshit to play against, and a little bit more, like, they've made it so, instead of just outright destroying the degreaser, and right now they have this glitched, apparently the degreaser's glitched, it's not meant to be this slow. Right now the switch from rate is exactly the same as the stock, so people complaining about, you know, it being too slow shouldn't really be, because hopefully they'll fix that, because right now there's no reason to use the stock. Like, they haven't fixed the degreaser in such a way that there's any reason to use the stock now, unless you really like Afterburn, because the only real nerf to the degreaser right now is the fact it costs 5 more ammo, which means you get 2 less air blasts, which is nothing. 5 more ammo is nothing. It's not like, you know, the huge 50 that it takes to fire the backburner. It's 5 more than it was. It's not that big of a deal. The heal on air blast is really cool. Little, you know, it doesn't always come into play, but for example, it means when you're sitting with your combo, and you're getting spammed by a soldier, a sniper, or whatever, the Pyro doesn't have to soak up heals from the medic. The medic instead can, you know, heal the demo man and the heavy, and due to the crossbow buff, that means you get ubercharge up to 10%, the medic will now take time out of his day to, you know, heal that scout across the map, maybe. Meaning that the game's faster, because it's not just, you know, medic healing the Pyro, like, the shit of it, until he's overhealed and then getting the rest of the combo. So it's good. The Pyro's now, you know, a little bit more self-sufficient, which is good. the flog buff is entirely unnecessary, but it's really fun to play with. I don't know. It was kind of unnecessary giving them Uber and no knockback, but I don't know. The removal of the damage penalty on that and the degreaser. Why would you use the stock? I don't think they're worried necessarily about the stock being underpowered. It's just more about people using the other two unlocks. You know, you've got the flog and you've got the backbone and you've got the degreaser. I don't think there's any other ones, are there? Missing one. I'm not sure, but those are the three. They don't care that much about the stock. They want the stock to apparently be like the air blast one, I guess. Except, you know, the 5 on the degreaser doesn't really mean anything. But previously the stock was like, you know, you could do a little bit more damage with it, so it's a little bit better for M1 and W, and less for combos. But now, you know, the degreaser's still good, Pyro's still good. The big thing is the ability to strafe now. Because long ago, like a couple of years ago, before the reserve shooter was out, maybe? I'm not sure. But air blasting someone used to just kind of turn their velocity around, which is let you ground stall, which if you jump and air blast them, they would kind of get stuck in the floor. And that was kind of cool, but it was kind of bullshit to play against. But Pyro used to be able to strafe out of the way, and then they changed the mechanics of the air blast, so it gives you a bit of a vertical boost up, meaning you can't ground stall. And it also completely removes their velocity. So if someone's rocket jumping at you at like 5,000 ham units, that gets set to 0, and then, you know, to whatever arbitrary value air blasting does. And, you know, puts you towards their crosshair, meaning that air blast became no skill. There's no skill in air blasts right now, because if you don't need to aim, it just kind of goes towards your crosshair, sorry. So Pyro kind of became a thing of like, can you left click, right click, and then aim at your crosshair? you know, as weird as it sounds, that's what it did. Air Blast pushed the player into your crosshair, so you didn't even have to aim. So right now, since you can actually strafe out of the way, you don't get stuck into a corner by a Pyro. The Pyro has to actually think before he combos you. Because right now, the buff to Pyro is that the just running at people with your mouse wand does way more damage than flare punching. You can do like 300 DPS or something like that. I'm sorry about that. But you can do a lot of damage now. So it's become less of can you left click, right click, to left click or anything. It's now like, can you kind of aim your flamethrower well enough to out DPS them? Because right now you can almost out DPS a heavy. If he hasn't seen you, you can out DPS a heavy. You do a lot of damage. But there's a lot of players that kind of just stuck to comboing and they never really learned how to aim their flamethrower. I think TMP made a video on this, the Pyroman, where he was like, people who only combo are going to be nerfed, but people who can combo and aim their flamethrower have got massive buff. Because, you know, right now, you can, if you see a scout or someone or an NG, you don't need to combo them. You can just hold down mouse one, and as long as you kind of aim ahead of them a bit and, you know, accompany, aim a little bit for the flames, because there's a bit of lag behind them, you'll do loads of damage now. But, you know, when it comes to a heavy, for example, you set them on fire for quite a bit, then you flare them, and then you set them on fire for a little bit, and you'll just kind of have to get used to the timings a little bit. Because right now, well, right now, before the update, what you did to fight heavies was you set them on fire, flare, set them on fire, flare, and the timings are going to be a little bit slower now, but it's not going to be that big of a deal. Because you do way more damage to your primary, so he'll probably die in the same amount of time or faster. But that aside, I think Pyro got a buff. Really, really definitely got a buff. I was playing Pyro in a pub earlier, and I was like, million kill streak, really easy. Flogs are really fun to play with, and it's really easy to counter. Anyone that's complaining about the flog being hard to counter doesn't know how to turn the other way and run away. It's not like he has increased move speed. Maybe what they might want to do, if they really, really want to keep it this way, is maybe make you move like 10% slower while you've got crits. I don't know. Make it a little bit easier to get away, but I don't know. I like Pyro as it is now, because when he was, you know, when he was created for TF2, he was kind of made to be the close range class, not the crit combo class, which he became. So I've liked that now he is like terrifying in close range. He'll do so much damage, which is good. I really like that. Because also Pyros used to be like, afterburn was a massive deal, because the only way to put them out was to be healed by a medic. I'm not even sure what medkits healed fire, but there was no air blast, there was no mad milk, there was no Jurati, there was none of that shit, there were no sandwiches. So if you got set on fire by Pyro, that's just 80 damage you have to take, or whatever, you know, all the ticks do. You know, that got kind of put away by all the anti-Pyro stuff in the game, like the Spicicle. But speaking of the Spicicle, let's move on a little bit. Spy update is really good. Right now, I think Gunspy is the strongest he's ever been in the history of this game. Even with the really, like, the original Dead Ringer with, like, you know, the 90 resistance that always stays at 90 and it lasts for a really long time and you can pick up more ammo to extend it and that kind of thing. It's even more powerful than that. 75 resistance is enough that rockets at super close range that hit you directly in the chest only do 25. And since most rockets will hit you in about the feet, they'll only do, like, 10. It's enough. 75% is enough to survive. You can survive a heavy shooting you with crits now, again, which you couldn't with the gunmetal one. It was really frustrating. If you accidentally got random crit from full health, you just instantly die. And they left in the speed boost and the Spicicle thing. It's so powerful. Like, holy shit. All the clips that I'm going to be using in this video are from two maps that I played over the course of, like, I don't know, like an hour. Like, 1 hour of gameplay. After, you know, like 2 hours in the past week. That's how powerful the weapon is now. You can use it to, like, ricochet between ammo packs and destroyed sentries. The Spicicle, what they've reworked it now. Spicicle now, compared to how it was, like, 2 years ago. The old Spicicle was silent kill, 15 seconds with no knife, I think. And then, like, 3 seconds of fire resistance or something. Something like that, I don't know. But, and then Gunmetal nerfed it, so it was just a afterburn extinguisher, basically. So I didn't really like it, but they've kind of changed it a bit, so it's still like that, but it... I can't explain it, but with the Dead Ringer buff, I'm finding myself using it with the Dead Ringer again. Because with the Gunmetal one, I saw no reason to use the Spicicle with the Dead Ringer. It was stupid. But now, it's really good, because it recharges at pretty much the same rate as the Dead Ringer, the Spicicle does. So I see no reason not to run them together, because the whole downside of not having a knife for 15 seconds is now moot, because you can run over a giant ammo pack and recover, like, several seconds of waiting time. So it's really good. If you find yourself I there'll be clips in here, I'm sure. I can't really explain it too well, but you can like basically just live forever and fuck pyros, basically. That's what this whole update was. It's just fuck pyros. But I'm not doing a good job of this. But you'll know what I mean. In that gun spy is really good now. You survive. You can run away super fast. And if you bunny hop, you don't have to be very good at bunny hopping. You just have to be able to hit the extra jump, and you can fly really far. Because, as you'll know, TF2 bunny hopping's severely nerfed to how it has been in like all the other Source games, like, Portal 1 and stuff, where you could jump backwards super fast. But in TF2, it only adds like an extra 5% of your speed. When you're running this like faster than a scout, that 5% speed's massive! That's like an extra 50 hammer units or something of speed, which is like 25% of your normal speed, so it's massive. It's a huge up. Meaning that you can go super duper fast and do lots of parkouring things. It's fun. I love the Derringer right now might actually be my favourite weapon in the game. I love mobility in games. I don't like being slow. So the ability to just kind of like go super fast whenever I want and then have it instantly recharge and also not die to soldiers on like 50 health is really good. It's really fun. And of course, the Ambi has never been nerfed because it's really balanced. It's, it rewards skill. And it's harder to use. It's a very balanced weapon. More weapons would be like this. But going on, I wanted to talk about a couple other things before I talk about... I didn't actually have anything planned. I'm actually just doing this kind of on the spot. But I want to talk about the kind of teamworky stuff quickly, just go over it. So it's very, really, really clear that competitive is like right around the corner, like 2016, around the corner. So you've got stuff like they are rewarding you now for milking and Jurati-ing and playing medic. Big thing is that medic's now really fun to play. Go play medic. Go get a friend or a stalker or pretend you have a friend with that guy in the pub even though you've never met. And play medic. It's really fun now. Because you're not just stuck to healing someone 24/7 and you're rewarded for it if you do. If you're low on health, you're rewarded for being a good medic and healing someone because your health recharges faster. If you are good with aiming your crossbow, and, I think this is right. I think shooting your crossbow at a heavy while he's in a heavy-v-heavy fight with another medic, you'll heal him faster than just holding down your medigun if you can hit all your crossbow shots. So now there's, it's a skill buff to medic where if you can aim your crossbow, you're even more kind of rewarded for doing it, which I think is really cool. And it also means that you will, as I said earlier in the video, you will take time out of your day to heal that one bloke who's next to you, like, medic, please heal me, I'm on 10 health. You'll pull out the crossbow because it's got the flare gun recharge now, where it kind of automatically reloads even if you don't have it equipped, and you'll get up to 10% Uber, and it's all good. They buffed the amputator to be how it always should have been, where like it gives you an Uber build, meaning that there's more viable weapons than just the Uber saw, which I think is really cool. They've made it so that the Vaccinator's really good again. The Vaccinator's really fun to play with. Genuinely really fun to play with. They made it so Uber Charge builds super fast. So playing Medic in the pregame isn't just kind of like a sluggish... Because it doesn't actually mean anything, it's arbitrary. But it kind of feels a little bit sluggish the way it builds so slowly before. It was only like 2 times or something. So you'd be a bit like, oh, do I have enough time to build an Uber? It's only 20 seconds left. No, I'll play something else. Now it's like, 20 seconds, I can build like 20 Uber charges in that time, it's great. All I want them to do now is make it so that you can build sentries and buildings instantly like an MVM. Because right now, setup time is moot, it's a moot point, no one really... The whole point of it was meant to be so like you can't put up like 20 sentries, but TF2's been out for like 20 billion years now, no one cares about that anymore. So I really think they should do that just to speed things up a little bit, and then maybe halve or drop the setup time to like 45 seconds or something, just to speed up the game a bit, because... Nowadays, setup time, like half of it, the last like 30 seconds, you're just tabbed out doing something else, waiting for the game to start, which is a bit boring. It's not Dota, it's not CS, we're not waiting in a lobby to play, we're just waiting for the map gates to open. So I don't know, I think they could speed up the game a little bit more doing that. And then that might allow for some more aggressive sentry placements, because you'll have time to build a level 3 sentry jump, build dispenser on the roof, that kind of shit. That would be really fun, and it would make playing NG fun, but because of all the NG nerfs, he wouldn't be super powerful, it would just be more fun to play. And it wouldn't slow down the game, if you know where I'm coming from with that, maybe? I don't know, I feel like they should keep balancing the game to kind of just work a bit faster, especially performance updates. This update, I'm getting like way more FPS. Some people have been reporting drops, apparently, and that will probably be because DX8, I suspect, because they are kind of pseudo-dropping support for DX8, remember, because matchmaking is only going to be DX9 people. So if you do have really low FPS, make sure you turn off Steam Beta. So, if you were in the trading cards when they first came out, that kind of thing, you'll be in the Steam Beta. So all you have to do is go into the Steam main Steam window, top left, open up settings, and it's in there somewhere, and you just change Steam beta participation to no thank you, no opt out of all programs. And you might get more frames if you do that, maybe, if you try. And another thing is that, like, they clearly know what the community wants, because they some of the update notes were like, let's have a look. General, that's not it. Performance improvements, here we go. Stuffing to do with graphics configs. They specifically mention popular graphics configs. Remember that, like, I don't know, 90%, maybe 80%, 70%, most of the TF2 community don't even know what a graphics config is. Most of the TF2 community is using stock HUD, 70 field of vision, 55 weapon FOV, I think, like motion blur and all this shit. Yet in the patch notes, they've clearly seen what the competitive community and what the, you know, hardcore kind of, you know, 500 to 5,000 hour people are playing with. And they've been like, okay, so everyone's apparently been having issues with low LODs on skins. Let's fix that. They've done that. Weapon sound jittering, which if you ever held up Netgraph before, you might actually notice that, I can't remember which color it is, but the color that sound was always the most jittery. It's now flat. There's almost no lag from sound now, which is amazing. They've made it so that it's faster to open your loadouts, so you can equip your hats faster than ever before. If you sit in spawn and, you know, you're worrying, oh shit, will I have enough time to equip my villain's veil, or do I have to wear my bruiser's bandana today? You don't have to think about that anymore. You've got 5 more seconds. It's really good. Of course, being facetious, but regardless, they're putting thought into this update. That's basically what I'm getting at. It wasn't just a thoughtless numbers in spreadsheet that's blanket update things. It's, you know, people want rebalances on these weapons and they don't find these things fun. No one's playing medics, so let's make medic more fun. NG kind of stalemates the game, let's make it less stalematey. Let's make it so that underused weapons, I mean, they're leaving some of them, like the volcano fragments, still underused, but and there are meant to be some joke weapons, I assume. Some things they're just going to leave be. And I'm fine with that. Like, you know, the Rap Assassin seems to be slowly moving out of the joke category into a potential, you know, annoying scout category, which is fine. He needs more. He doesn't need more weapons. He's got millions. But it's nice to have more weapons, is what I'm saying. So I'm like, you know, when Six comes out, it won't always just be scattergun, pistol, Boston Basher, maybe Winger. It will be like, you know, oh, I'm going to run the Rap Assassin this mid, and, you know, I'm gonna, you know, hit their medic for, you know, like 20 damage, and then our soldier can bomb him, and, you know, that kind of thing. It'll be interesting. They won't, oh, bless me, it won't actually mean much, but I like that they're doing small little things like that. They aren't just leaving stuff to the bin like they've done with, that, like, done for so long. Like, the Scorch Shot was useless for, like, fucking 20 billion years, and now it's really good. I love the Scorch Shot now. It's like an air of effect flare gun, that's what it is, literally. But it's balanced, kinda. It's good. It's a good weapon. But, what else is there? There's some other stuff I wanted to talk about. Oh, yeah. Little things, like, they've made it so that you can remove gifted gift names from gift wraps, which, I mean, if you're not into trading at all, this doesn't really mean much, but this is a massive deal for trading. I think it's a really good thing, personally, because right now, a lot of people that have gifted unusuals either had them signed for them, traded for them by accident, or bought them because they're cheaper. So now it basically just means that there's more unusuals on the market, which is really good. I like that. A lot of the Circling Hearts villain's veils are duped from ones signed by Jake, the American Sniper. So now all of those are going to be, like, proper value. They're not just going to be like, oh, the owner wants more for him and it's signed, but it's gifted. I don't want to pay for that. Now it's going to be like, the owner wants market value for his hat, so I'm going to pay that. I like that. And also it means that I've had, like, one or two people ask me to sign, like, their unusuals, and I've been like, I can't do that, you'll drop the value on it so much. But now, I'm fine with doing that, because, you know, they can just take the tag off if they really don't want it, which I think is quite good. And it also means that people can remove, you know, people that they don't like from the signed weapons. So if you trade for one and it's got, like, you know, some man that they don't particularly like on it, they can just kind of be like, ooh, you know, fuck that man, I'm going to get it re-signed now. Also, fucking, what are they called? Strange Count Transfer Tools. Thank you! Very much. Oh god, I've been waiting for these for so long. And they've done them in the way they should be done. So instead of just doing like a swap tool where, you know, kills from A go to kills B, but kills B swap to kills A, they've done it so everything from A goes into everything on B. But they've also added a weird thing, is that the strange parts don't get reset if the receiving weapon doesn't have that parts. So right now, my old sniper rifle, which had 5,000 kills on it, had a critical kills part, but my festive one, which now has like 1,100,000,000,000 on it, doesn't have a critical kills part. So even though the original rifle has now got zero kills, it's also still got, like, you know, a bunch of critical kills on it, which I think is kind of weird. But it also means that, like, you can... If you just want to swap from one weapon to the other, but you can't afford the strange parts yet, you can do that. And then later, you can swap the strange parts over, I think. Which I think is nice. It's a nice little thing. It won't mean too much, but it's nice that they at least put the thought in instead of literally just copying and pasting it from CSGO, because there's no strange parts in CSGO, of course. But I like that. Also, the fact that it's craftable is awesome. Bit annoying, because I might have spent 10 quid on strange parts just getting a couple of them. But, you know, they kind of made it so that strange parts have gone up from, like, you know, 10 pence, no one wants them, to, like, a pound each. Which I think is kind of nice for the owners that want, that have had them for a really long time and can't sell them. I'm hoping that they release more crates with more parts, though, because then that might buff unboxing a little bit. Oh, unboxing! Another thing. They made it so that it's kind of got the Dota 2-esque system. Ooh, it's got the Dota 2-esque system now, where it's like, you know, you won't unbox three SMG skins in a row. You'll get an SMG skin that's red, and then you'll get a blue one, and then you'll get a pistol skin. And I like that. They've made it so unboxing's a little bit more fun, so people will want to do it more, so there'll be more unusuals on the market, which will be nice. And that's basically what I wanted to talk about that with that. But yes, I like that they've done that. I'm a bit annoyed right now, though, because you can't put kills from a sniper rifle onto an AWP, but that's okay. That's fine. We don't want to worry about that. And there's, you know, some other little things, like they changed the scoreboard around. I'm going to have to fix that in my HUD, because right now my scoreboard looks awful. I can't see anything. I'm going to have to fix that. They've apparently changed some weapon firing things. I don't really care about that. They've added some advanced options and shit. They've changed the ping by default to be like the Left 4 Dead one with just like the bars, which is kind of stupid. But I guess it makes sense. I think some people who are not really into PC gaming will think, oh, high ping must be good. Whereas, of course, you know, it's not. It's the distance from the server. It's how long it takes a packet to come, you know, ping back and forth. That's what ping means. So, you know, it's a bit better for more casual players. But you can go into advanced settings and change it back to numbers. You just go do that now. Go do that. It means you can blame people for having 800 ping again, which is good. But also, apparently they've added a crate unboxing animation. I haven't seen that yet, but that might make it more fun to do. I don't know. But that's pretty much it. I've covered everything I really wanted to. Like, some of the weapon changes were quite nice. Like, the reserve shooter's still really strong, but it's not nearly as strong. They've made the panic attack apparently less shit. It might be fun to play with. Beggar's Bazooka did need a nerf. Base Jumper, I'm not sure why they removed the updraft. I always thought that was kind of a fun little thing. Market Gardener, very good example of how in comp servers no random crits, so the Market Gardener was a direct upgrade, and you could one-shot medics with it. So the fact they've just added a small little, you know, swing sweet bonus means that, you know, they know about random crits, they know. Carbine, still shit. Cozy Camp is fun, go use it, it's really fun now, I'd recommend it. I've talked about Pyro, talked about Medic, Spy, it's very strong, go play Spy. The Eviction Notice, apparently, the 15% move speed bonus is permanent, you don't have to hold the weapon out. It gives you a small damage taken increase, which means you basically have 250 health, I think, 260. However, you have a permanent speed up, which I think is kind of cool. So it means if you're playing like shotgun heavy, you know, it's a joke weapon, I think. If you're playing like a joke weapon heavy, you can now run around with your shotgun a little bit faster. I quite like that. It's a nice little change. The Warrior Spirit's a little bit more, yeah, less of a joke weapon now. It's a bit more powerful of a joke weapon. And they're, you know, they're nerfing the Gru and the Fists of Steel. I assume they just don't want people running him in sixes because they know that, like, you know, actual people that main heavy are going to fuck up matchmaking because it's going to be really boring. I don't know. But, yeah, that's pretty much it. They've done a couple of little things, like, you know, the Huntsman can now be fired from the air. Pyro nerf, pretty much, like, maybe a Soldier nerf when you launch them into the air, but that's not that important. New maps, beautiful. If you haven't played them yet, really would recommend them. Vanguard is a comp. It was in a comp map. I think it's in UGC. It's kind of shit in comp, to be honest. I played it with Samsung, I think, Samsung Galaxy gang, and it was kind of a roll, so I kind of got bored and kept going to the wrong spawn, so like we'd be attacking their last, and I'd end up walking to our last, because I'm an idiot, but like, it's not very good. In TF2, you know, blue and metallic means blue team, red and wood and natural colours means red team, and that map Vanguard kind of seems to fuck with that a little bit, which is a shame, but... yeah, it's a pretty good fun pub map, I think. The payload map is really fun.
The Capture the Flag map with the giant trees. It's beautiful. It's a really nice map. I love Borneo-y maps. And this is almost kind of like Borneo. It reminds me of like... what does it remind me? It reminds me of like... I can't think of it. But it's fun. It's a jungle, almost. It's cool. I like it. And the Koth map, I think, could definitely be played in comp. It seems really comp viable. It's kind of like...
Viaduct?
Yeah. It's a little bit like Viaduct in the way it's played. And I kind of like that. It's a mix between Viaduct and Coal Plant or whatever it is. You know, the one with the... Asheville. The one with the under the point bit, which I like. I hope it does get played in the future because it's kind of fun. But that's pretty much it. I think I've covered pretty much everything I wanted to. TLDR, the update was great. Pyro's been rebalanced to be a little bit more aimy your flamethrower-y and less combo-y. Spy's been rebalanced to be really fun. Medic's been rebalanced to be fun. Engie's been nerfed. I'm sorry, Engie mains. But that's it. That was it. That's all I wanted to talk about. So I think I'll just end the video here. I hope you enjoyed yourself. I will see you all next time. Goodbye.